Capture the essence of a situation or emotion or the greatness of a person. Actions do, and Dad proved that time and time again. Yesterday, as a family, I think we learned how much Dad touched everyone's lives through the words of encouragement, being there when people needed him. And we thank you for coming and sharing those stories with us yesterday. As far as my father goes, it was hard to narrow down the stories from childhood to adulthood on what touched me the most. But I tried to narrow it down to three topics. The first is family. Family was the most important thing in the world to my dad. We grew up with the concept that family is everything. We grew up in an environment that was very close no matter what happened. I always knew that our family was going to stick together. My dad grew up in a couple different states, for those that don't know, California and Florida and Iowa. They moved a bit, and I think this is where his take on family originated from. His parents and his sister were very close. And I know he loved them very, very much. Our last trip to California in September was to see old family and friends. But I really think it was to get his mom and his sister together one last time to reminisce, stick his toes in the sand. I usually tease Dad that he loved family so much, he had three of them. Mike and I were the first. Us being the first really tested Dad. I remember him making us watch The Godfather with him when we were young, probably too young, after one of our knockdown, drag-out fights. And then him explaining what family truly meant to us in his best Godfather voice he did. Then 9 years later, apparently he hadn't had enough. He started another family, and him and Mom had Bradley and Brit. So us two older ones got to watch him raise our little brother and sister. We witnessed what a loving and encouraging and fun daddy was like. We remembered him singing old rock songs and dancing in the kitchen with Brittany. I catch myself doing a lot of those things with my daughter and my kids. I remember Dad making my little brother a wooden airplane that he rode around the house. And those that, you know, my dad was a mechanic, and so carpentry probably wasn't his best skill. But I think that is where the original saying originated from, that it's not too bad for a mechanic. And then later us boys kind of morphed into it's good enough for mechanics. And that was something we held in pride. And then 21 years later, Dad and Mom started their third family when our sister JoJo came into our lives. And honestly, I think that's when I truly saw how much unconditional love my father had and what he had to give. He loved us all so much, but no one as much as my mother. He loved her unconditionally. He was stuck with us kids, but he chose my mom. That unconditional love and unwavering love kind of showed us what it takes to make a marriage work and what it takes to make a family work. I want to be grateful for that. That was the first topic, so I got two more. Sorry. Friendship is the second one I want to talk about, because that was very important to my father. He had many great friends over the years. I know he had thoroughly enjoyed the fire service and the brothers that he created there. I love listening to him tell me all the crazy stories from his childhood to his adulthood. I don't know if he ever really grew up. But he also enjoyed morning golf outings. He also enjoyed his favorite pastime, which was standing out in front of the shop. And if anyone stopped, he'd be willing to talk and listen. It's just something he really enjoyed doing. The last thing I want to talk about is answering the call. I think you can look at it a lot of different ways. Be it from coaching Little League, being a scout leader, volunteering at the church, being on the fire department. What my dad believed was you should speak out when you see something wrong and you should try and correct it. Do whatever you could. I believe my brother said it best last night. He said the last couple days have been an eye-opening. When we look at all the good traits each of us kids have, we got the majority of them from my dad. Over the last several years, my dad and I had many long conversations related to fire service mostly, bad calls, how to handle situations, or what new cool tools he got and what we had gotten. And that's probably going to be the biggest void in my life. He always knew the right question to ask me, so I had come to the right conclusion on my own. He was really, really good at that. Which leads me to one last story. What actually happened last night? Yesterday was an extremely long and trying day. And during my drive home, I contemplated a lot of what I was going to say today. It was just after 11 and I was pulling into Urbana. And how you get my house, you go right, you go to my house, you go left, you go to the station. And when I was coming up on that turn, my pager went off. That's not how it goes, right, guys? So at that moment, I had to make a decision. I was really exhausted. I was tired. I had a long day. Two things happen. You always have that voice in your head. It's like a conscience, right? That thing that speaks to you. Well, last night was different. Last night, instead of telling me what to do, the voice asked me a question. And it was my father's voice. He said, if you don't step up, who else will? Lead by example. So I turned left. I went to the station. And at that moment, I realized that Dad isn't really gone. He lives with all of us, everyone that knew him. And if you listen really hard, I can hear. And I think I will carry that the rest of my life. He meant the world to me. He was my hero. As we move forward today to honor my father, I ask that you all smile and celebrate my father's life. He was so much to so many. Just remember, he'll be with us if you need him. I thank you all for being here.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, you abide in the shadow of the light. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. In those days, I, Daniel, mourned and heard this word of the Lord. At that time there shall arise Michael, the great prince, guardian of your people. It shall be a time unsurpassed in distress, since nations began until that time. At that time your people shall escape, everyone who is found written in the book. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake. Some shall live forever. Others shall be in everlasting horror and disgrace, but the wise shall shine brightly, like the splendor of the firmament. And those who lead the many to justice shall be like the stars forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live in the Lord. And if we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an accounting for himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Support of one another, consolation of God. I got to know Don while I was here in Fayette. I remember going to his shop up in Maynard just to say hi and to listen, visit him. His shop was one of my hideouts when things got kind of tricky around here. And I think perhaps that's the way many people knew him. Someone who was always there, a good friend, and someone who was genuinely focused on bringing goodness to others. I was reading his obituary in the paper, and I was struck by all the ways that he did this, all the ways he brought God's goodness with him. As a husband, a father, he brought goodness to wife, children, grandchildren. The obituary said he was in the scouting, an Eagle Scout leader in scouting as well. A 28-year member of the Maynard Fire Department, first as a captain, then fire chief as well, 8 years, I think. I want to welcome especially all the first responders who are here today. Thank you for coming. There's more, so much more than the goodness he brought as mechanic, through contact with people, his commitment to the community as well. Director and coach of Little League for many years. He was involved here, in this place. He was on our parish council. I so appreciated the last line of the obituary. He loved his family and his friends dearly. I think that pretty well sums things up. He loved his family, he loved his friends. And when we love, that's what allows us to give of ourselves to one another. That's what allows us to make sacrifice for others. The love that we have. Again, Don loved his family and friends dearly. One thread connects all these relationships and commitments and activities. The thread of service. Don was a servant to his family, his community, his church, to his friends. And notice how this fits in with the gospel reading we heard. It came from the Gospel of John. It described Jesus at the Last Supper with his disciples. And Jesus knows what's going to happen. He knows he will be betrayed and put to death. So he gives to his friends one last lesson. Because it's the last one, probably the most important, he gets up, takes off his outer garment, wraps a towel around his waist, then begins to wash his disciples' feet. When he finished, he says, if I therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash another's. For that as I have done for you, you should also do. Jesus ends by saying, if you understand this, blessed are you if you do it. Blessed are you if you serve. So clear. Don understood this teaching. All the service he did, all that he was involved in, all the sacrifice he made for others. Again, the words of Jesus. If you understand this, blessed are you. If you do it, if you serve, blessed are you. With this knowledge of God's blessing, we can turn to the words of St. Paul. He speaks of what takes place following our death. He speaks of why it's so important to follow the teachings of Jesus. Because each of us belongs to God. He says, no one lives for oneself, no one dies for oneself. We live for the Lord. If we die for the Lord. Whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. And he says something most important. He says that each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. That one day, all of us will stand before the judgment seat of God. For some, the judgment that awaits each of us can be a cause of worry and concern, especially if we're living solely for ourselves. But if we are of good faith, we are able to hope and to look forward. For faith in God allows us to open our hearts to its mercy, mercy that transforms us into who God would have us be and allows us to do what God would have us do, to serve one another. Again, the words of Jesus so clear. We are to serve just as Jesus served all of us, died for us on the cross, that we might know his love for us, so that one day we will be received into eternal life. For that is his plan for each of us. This is our hope for God. We We're not concerned for him, but we know he had a servant's heart. We believe that God will receive him with love and with mercy. We also trust in God that we ourselves will receive this gift. We need his love and mercy this day, this time of sadness, and in the days ahead as well, because life will be different without Don. So while we entrust the soul of Don to God, so we also entrust ourselves to God. We might continue to serve one another, just as Don served so many. Finally, we give thanks, even though it's difficult. We give thanks to God for the way Don touched our lives. We give thanks for the servant's heart that God gave to him, for the way he brought God's goodness to so many. We continue to give thanks as we go forward from this place, as we live our lives in faith, trusting in God and in hope the days ahead, days when we will be reunited with all those we love, with God.
We are one body in this life, Lord. Gentile or Jew, servant or free, woman or man.
The fire service is rich with ceremony, custom, and tradition. Our custom of rendering final honors has its origins in the fire department of the city of New York, where many years ago, long before the advent of radios or pagers, fire alarms and daily announcements were dispatched from central headquarters to outlying firehouses by a system of bell commands and telegraph. Each different type of alarm or announcement would have its own number and series of bell strikes. When a firefighter died in the line of duty, or when some important official personage died, headquarters would transmit 5 bell strikes, repeated in 4 series, with a slight pause in between, followed by the announcement. This was done as long ago as 1865 in the New York City Fire Department to inform the rank and file of the death of Abraham Lincoln. The custom is continued down to present day, and this form of rendering final honors to departed comrades is known in the fire service as striking the 4 fives. I ask that the Buchanan County Honor Guard, members of the Maynard Fire Department, visiting fire departments, and EMS members, active and retired, please rise and come to attention. Present arms. Signal 5555 has been transmitted. It is with deep regret that the Maynard Fire Department announces the death of its member, Donald Paul Westendorf Jr. Don has completed his assignment and has returned home. Please be seated.
us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we, who mourn, be reunited one day with our brother. Together may we meet Christ Jesus, but he who is our life appears in heaven. Our citizenship is in heaven. From it we also await the Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, your hallowed graves have all believed in you. So made the grave a sign of hope. Promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our brother may sleep here in peace, till you awaken him to glory. You are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God. Live and reign forever and ever. Because God has chosen to call our brother from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth. We are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen the firstborn from the dead. Let us commend our brother to the Lord. The Lord may embrace him in peace. Raise up his body on the last day. For our brother Don, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Don by the tears of those who weep. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We raise the dead to life. Give to our brother eternal life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring down to the joys of heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Brother was washed in baptism, anointed with the Holy Spirit. Have fellowship with all your saints. Lord, have mercy. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Comfort us in our sorrow, the death of God. Let our faith be our consolation, eternal life our hope. Lord, have mercy. Longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant. Do not count his deeds against him, for in his heart he desired always to do your will. As his faith united him to your people on earth, so may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need. Strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ, our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We pray that Almighty God may bless this crucifix, make it holy, so that all who cast their gaze upon it might be reminded the love of our God, the service, Jesus Christ our Lord. Be inspired to serve the same way. Thy blessing, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
So free like you prayed. It's so warm, so bright, and so beautiful. All my fears and my pain have gone away. 'Cause here in heaven, oh, I miss you so. But now please go and spread your wings and seize the day. I'm okay 'cause I'm dancing in the sky. Each day I'm singing that you go and live your life. Never give up, one day we will reunite. The sun shines so bright here in heaven. I'm at peace, I'm happy, and I'm free. And someday walk these clouds together. First, you must go on and see the world for me. 'Cause here in heaven, oh, I miss you so. But I know we'll meet someday. But now, please go. Spread your wing and seize the day. I'm okay 'cause I'm dancing in the sky. Each day I'm singing in the angel's choir. I hope that you go and live your life. Give up, one day we will reunite, I'm dancing in the sky. Each day I'm singing in the angels' choir. I hope that you go and live. night.